Hi everyone. Earlier we looked at monopoly profit maximization by looking at a table. This time we're going to look at a graph and see how we can figure out what quantity the monopolist should produce in order to maximize its profits. So let's graph the revenue curves first of all. So we have a downward sloping demand curve. So let's say that the demand curve looks like this for the monopolist. We know that in unit 6 for the purely competitive firm, the demand curve that one firm faces was horizontal. That means the product is purely elastic. The demand curve here for the monopolist is more inelastic because the monopolist, of course, doesn't face competition, or not a whole lot of competition in any case. So here's the demand curve. And then we also saw from the last section in this unit that the marginal revenue curve lies below the demand curve. So let's say that this is the marginal revenue curve. Now let's graph the average and marginal cost curves. So let's say that for this monopolist, the average variable cost curve is here. It's average variable cost. And then the average total cost curve is going to be above it, because average total also includes fixed costs. So there's the average total cost. And let's say that the marginal cost curve, let's give that a little different color. Marginal cost curve looks like this. It's supposed to go through the bottom parts of those two average curves. So here's your marginal cost curve. The profit maximizing rule for any firm in any industry is MC is equal to MR, and that's where we have the maximum profit. So if you look at the intersection of the purple and that black curve, MC is the purple curve, and then this black curve is the MR curve, the marginal revenue curve. So that is where marginal cost equals marginal revenue. So if we draw a line straight down to the quantity axis, this is the quantity where this monopolist is maximizing its profit. So let's call it QPM. Now, what is the price that this monopolist will charge? We don't go straight across horizontally to the vertical axis to figure that out, because that's MC and MR, and MR and MC are different from the price. So what we have to do for the monopolist, we have to go to the demand curve. Demand curve indicates the price, of course. And so at the profit maximizing quantity that we indicated, we go straight up to the demand curve. And then this is where we have the profit maximizing price. There's one more thing we can do, and that is to identify the profit area. Now, if you look at QPM, and you go straight up to the average total cost, so that gives us the cost per product produced. If we draw a line straight across here, we would get the average total cost for the profit maximizing quantity. In the table that we used earlier in the video, that average total cost was $5.75. The price in that table was $8. So if this is 8 and this is $5.75, then we know that the average profit, price minus average total cost, the average profit is 8 minus 575 is 225. Also in that same table in the video, we know that we produced 40 products at the profit maximizing quantity, so that we know that 40 times 225, the length times the width of this rectangle, represents the total profit. 40 times 225 is equal to 90. So we see here that the monopolist makes positive economic profit. Any positive economic profit means that this is an above normal profit. A because we saw in Unit 5, where we talked about costs, that costs include not only explicit costs, but also implicit costs. So any positive economic profits are above normal profits. In the long run, for this monopolist, it's very possible that this firm can continue to make these profits because there are high barriers to entry. This was not the case for purely competitive firms. We saw that for purely competitive firms, if these firms were making positive economic profits, other firms, other competitors would come into the industry, it would increase the supply of the product, the price would then go down, and then the economic, positive economic profits would disappear in the long run for purely competitive firms. So that's not necessarily the case for the monopolist here. The monopolist can continue to make these profits. Now, it's not to say that there will always be profits in every year for even for a monopoly. There are monopolists in the real world that during certain years incur losses, so that's certainly possible as well.